Hello everyone. This topic is from the unit Computer Arithmetic, and we are going to see the addition and subtraction with sine magnitude data. So first of all, we need to see that what is the difference between unsigned data and signed data. Now in unsigned data, we do not consider the sign plus or minus, right? So whether I am having plus 5 or a minus 5, in unsigned data it's a 5 only, right? So there is no need to consider the sign, right? Whereas in a signed data, 5, that means it's not only 5, I have to give the sign also, whether it is a plus 5 or a minus 5, right? So when we perform addition or subtraction with the sine magnitude data, there is a vast difference, because if we do with the unsigned data, there is always addition, means only addition is performed, and if I perform subtraction, then subtraction only is performed, right? But if I work with the addition in a sine magnitude data, then I have a few possibilities. For example, if my both the number is positive number, that is plus 5 and plus 5, and if I perform addition between these two number, right? So that is my plus 10, right? If I am having two negative numbers, that is minus 5 and a minus 5, and if I perform addition in between this, so I am having the answer, that is minus 10. Again, there is an addition only the sign that I need to consider, that is a minus, right? But now there is a one more thing, that if one number I'm having, that is my positive number, and another number, that is my negative number, and if I apply the addition operation, then also it will perform subtraction, right? And the answer here is 0. Why? Because my one number is a positive number and the another number is a negative number, right? So this thing we need to consider in sine magnitude data, same as in a subtraction also, right? So what we need to keep in mind, that is, if both the sign of both the number, here I am having number 1 and here I am having number 2, if sign of this both number are same, then the same operation will be performed, whether it is an addition operation or a subtraction operation. But if I am having a different sign, suppose my number 1 is having negative sign and number 2 is having positive sign, or else my number 1 is having positive sign and number 2 is a negative sign, means two different sign is there, then if I am performing addition, then the reverse operation, that subtraction, is performed, right? And if I am performing subtraction, then addition will be performed, right? So this we need to keep in mind when we work with the sine magnitude data in addition and subtraction. Now here I am having the flow chart. This is the flow chart for the addition and subtraction of the sine magnitude number, right? So here I am having subtraction operation and here I am having addition operation, right? So in a A, I am having minute and subtrahend in a B, right? And here for addition operation, my augment in A and addend in B, right? Now what I am doing, here I am comparing the thing. We need to compare whether the both the signs are same or not, right? If both the signs are same, so in an addition operation, we are going to perform addition only, right? And if both the signs same in subtraction operation, then we'll perform subtraction only. But if the signs are different in addition operation, then we are going to perform the subtraction. And if the signs are different in subtraction operation, then we are going to perform the addition, right? So this we need to keep in mind. Now how we are going to know that whether the both the signs are same or not, right? So for that we are going to use this XOR operation, right? So AS and BS, my minute is in A and subtrahend in a B. Similar way, if I perform addition, augment in A and addend in B, right? So AS, that is sine bit of A, and BS, that is sine bit of B. Here same, AS, that is sine bit of A, and BS, that is sine bit of B, right? So we are XORing the sine bit, right? Now what is the output of XOR gate? If the both the numbers are same, then it will return 0, and if both the numbers are different, then it will return 1, right? So here I am checking that AS XOR BS, right? So if I am performing AS XOR BS and both are same, that means it is equal to 0, right? this is equal to 0, that means what? Here I have to perform subtraction only. This is for the subtraction only, right? And here same, AS XOR BS, if both are same, that means I am performing addition only, right? So here I am performing addition. Why? Because my AS is equal to BS, and here also my AS is equal to BS, so I am performing subtraction. So in addition, I am performing A plus B, that means my entire number A is added with the entire number B, and we are storing it in a EA, where A is not a normal accumulator, E is an extended accumulator. If overflow is generated, then that overflow bit will be stored in E, right? And then after that, we are storing this overflow bit in an AVF. AVF, that is a flag for to represent the overflow, right? Now, in a similar way, if I want to perform a subtraction, so for the subtraction, how we perform subtraction? So for that, we need to add the 2's complement of a subtract, right? I have to add 2's complement of subtrand to my minute, right? So what I am doing, I am complementing my B, that is B bar plus 1. So this is my 2's complement of B, and I am adding this 2's complement of B into A, right? And again EA, why? Because to generate overflow, to store the overflow, right? But in subtraction operation, AVF is always 0 because there is no overflow in subtraction operation, right? So this is my normal subtraction, and here I'm having addition. Now if both the signs are different, right, AS and BS, whether it can be plus, AS can be plus, BS can be minus, or AS can be minus and BS can be plus, that means both the numbers are different, then your XOR will result in 1, right? That means instead of the subtraction operation, you have to perform the addition operation, right? So we are directly directing this to this addition operation, right? Similar way here, in addition operation, if my both the signs are different, then we are directing this in a subtraction operation, right? So, I think this is clear, right? Now, after this, this addition is performed. There is no need further because we perform the addition and we store the overflow in the AVF, right? But there is a difference in subtraction operation. Why? Because we are having 2 options in subtraction, right? Whether I am having A that is greater than B, and the second scenario, that is my A is less than B, right? Here I am having greater than or equal to B, and A is less than B, right? So if my A is greater than or equal to B, then whatever answer I am receiving, that is my positive answer, right? That always is positive because A is minute is greater. So A is greater than or equal to B, then whether I can get positive answer, and if A is equal to B, then I'll get 0. Right, if both the numbers are same, then I'll get 0, and if A is greater than B, then I get the answer that is in the positive form. But if A is lesser than B, if A is lesser than B, then whatever the answer that is in the negative form. Now if the answer is in negative form, that means whatever I'm getting, that is not my actual answer, that is the answer in the 2's complement form, right? So again I have to get the original answer. So for getting the original answer, what I am doing, I'm checking the E, right? If E is equal to 1, right, then that means what? A is greater than or equal to B, and if A is greater than or equal to B, then it can be either, if A is equal to B, right, then my answer is 0, otherwise it's a not 0. If it is not 0, that means whatever the answer, that is my correct answer. And if it is equal to 0, then we are assigning the AS to the 0. Why this is needed? Because we are ignoring the negative 0 situation, right? That it might be possible there is an answer that is negative 0. So we are negative 0, that is not possible, right? So we are creating we are generating this negative sign into the positive one. So it is, instead of 1, it will be 0, right? So we are checking the A. If A is 0, then we'll set the AS is equal to 0. If A is not equal to 0, then as it is, right, we are doing this. Now the second scenario, if A is less than B, if A is less than B, that means my subtrand is greater than my minute, right? That means I'm getting the answer. That answer is in a negative form, right? So again, what we need to do, we need to apply the 2's complement, and after applying the 2's complement, whatever the answer is, that is my original answer, right? So for that, what I need to do, how we can go, how we can do 2's complement? So first we need to complement A, that is A bar, right? I'm applying the A bar to the A, that means 1's complement is done. Then I'm adding 1 into this. That means 1's complement plus 1. That is my 2's complement, right? So that is my that is stored in A. That means now A is having 2's complement of whatever the answer I'm receiving over here, right? So right now at this stage, I'm having the original answer, right? And after this, I have to assign the sign bit, right? So sign bit, I have to complement the sign bit. Why? Because I'm already getting the negative answer, right? So for the negative answer, I need to complement the sign bit, right? So for that, AS, that is equal to AS bar, right? And at the end, or it is completed, and my result is, that is in A and AS, right? I'm getting the result in my A, and whatever the sign I'm getting, that is in the AS. AS, that is sign bit of A, and my result is stored in A. So this is the flow chart of addition and subtraction of sign magnitude number. I hope you are clear about this, right? Thank you.